The last thing we need to show is that there isn't an easier way to compute D than finding the factors of N. This follows from what we just showed, that if we know the totient, we could easily find the factors, because the correctness of RSA depends on this property. That means that there's some integer k such that k times the totient of n is equal to ed minus 1, which means, well, we already know the value of e. We're assuming now that we figure out a way to compute d. If we can solve this, then we know a multiple of the totient. Once we know a multiple of the totient, it's easy to find the factors p and q. So if there were some easier way to find d than factoring the modulus, that would provide an easy way to factor. So we finished showing that all the obvious mathematical ways of breaking RSA would easily allow us to factor n. This certainly doesn't cover issues in implementation or issues in weak choices of messages or keys. But assuming all of those things are good, then we've shown that all the obvious mathematical ways to break RSA are equivalent to factoring n. So that means if factoring is hard, breaking RSA would be hard. So that's the second part of this claim, is that factoring is indeed hard.